name is Pawan Nitish and I am your Abhyas IIT Prep coordinator. Okay, this Abhyas IIT Prep is a part of Gyanvil Academy. Okay, so today I am going to discuss with you about CSAB counseling. Okay, CSAB counseling is Central Seat Allocation Board, which is participating in the JOSA special rounds. Okay, JOSA special rounds are done in this portal. Okay, so now. So Central Seat Allocation Board, as I have said, this is the part, this is the main authority for this counseling process. Okay, it has released list of participating institutes in the website. Okay, so far there are 31 NITs and one IIEST Srivipur, and also 26 IIITs and 29 government funded technical institutions are also participating in this process. Okay, except IITs, all the main institutes are participating in this process, or you can call the cluster as NIT plus system. So if you want to check all the participating institutes also, you can check out the source given below. I will paste it again in the description also. So expected timelines. Okay, expected timelines. Display of the vacancy list. First thing is, for special rounds they will display the vacancy list. That vacancy list is displayed on 16th November, okay, from 5 o'clock. And then registration and payment of processing fee starts from 17th November, okay, 17th November, and it is up to 19th November. Okay, first round one starts from 20th November. Here first in A, there is exercising any one of the options given below. Either you have to accept the seat, okay, and then choose freeze, float or slide, which I have explained to you in the previous JOSA video also. You can check that one. I will give the description, the link, description link also. Okay, next, if you are not happy, you will select float or you will select slide. Okay, all these options, or you will surrender the allotted seat and participate for the next round, or if you are surrendering the allotted seat and not participating in the next round, or not allotted any seat and then you are participating for the next round. Okay, these outcomes will come in between 20th to 23rd November. Next, online reporting is only for the people who got a seat. Okay, who got a seat, for those people online reporting is there. Okay, process listed A is only mandatory for candidates, only for who got a seat in the CSAB special round 1. Okay, A and B is for allotted a seat in the first time. You will do the reporting only if you are getting it in the first time. Okay, last day to the respond to the query is how much? 24th November. Okay, 24th November. Then next, display of seat allotment result of special round 2 is on 24th November. Okay, display, after display you will select an option. If you are getting a seat allotted, then you have to go and report at the allotted institute, and that is from 25th to 30th November. Okay, so next is about the preference list. For you, if you want to fill the choices, you need a preference, right? So for that reference, I have given you these two links, which are the last year opening and closing ranks for the special round 1 and special round 2. Okay, you can check them. I will paste them in the description. Next, eligibility. Who can participate? So who have allotted a seat, the candidates who had got allotted a seat in JOSA in NIT plus system, and then who have allotted a seat in JOSA rounds earlier but they had opted for seat withdrawal, okay, or their seat was cancelled during document verification. And also people who has not registered on the JOSA portal, or not opted, or opted the exit option from the JOSA portal, or seat was allotted in IITs, or seat was cancelled due to non-reporting. All these people, everyone can participate in the CSAB portal process. Okay, so first thing you have to do is registration. In the registration, all the eligible candidates are to be applying or registering in the given website there in between the dates 17 to 19 November after seeing the display of vacancies. Okay, next, in during registration process, you have a chance for updating your state of eligibility and nationality and gender if there are any mistakes. Okay, this is the last chance for you to rectify them. Next, payment. Payment. Payment, I will tell you only simple thing. You can check those slides later also. One thing is, if you have not paid any fees till now for any institute, any of the rounds, then in CSAB while participating first time, you have to pay 37,000. Okay, for general candidates, general EWS candidates, and also for the OBC non-creamy layer candidates. If you are any other category, SC, ST, PWD candidates, then you have to pay 17,000 rupees for the first time, if you are paying it for the first time. And in that 37,000 or the 17,000 you are paying, 2,000 is already included, which is called as processing fee, and that is non-refundable. Okay, next, the candidates who have already paid the CSOB. See, if you are not participating in the CSOB only for the first time, you have participated earlier in some other process like JOSA, then you have already paid, if you got a seat, you have already paid some fees, right? Participating fee. So, in here, you no need to pay the any participating fee, you have to pay only the processing fee, that is 2000 rupees. Okay, even if you have already took a seat and then you have paid partial admission fee also in the JOSA, then no need to pay again, you have to pay only 2000. For the first time, if you are paying for a seat in a college, you have to pay the above mentioned in the first point. Okay, or all the other cases you have to pay only 2000. Next, choice filling and logging. In choice filling and logging, first thing is, if you have any filled choices in the JOSA portal, those will not be there for the CSAB. You have to start again freshly. Okay, the last, if you have secured any seat in JOSA, that will be the last choice in the CSAB portal automatically. Even if it is not showing in their portal, you have to take it as a last choice. Next, candidates should always save their choices time to time, because if there is any network issue or any power issue, and if your choices are not saved, they can't be again retracted. So every time after filling the choices, please save the choices carefully. Next, reporting. So for reporting, what you will do is, after completion of the special rounds, candidates who has got confirmed the seat allotment, okay, they have to go to the center and report in time between 25th to 30th November. Okay, then you have to complete all the formalities and then your seat is confirmed. One thing, like, there is some important notes in the last. Okay, this is an online process, so every time there is a chance of the expected timelines to change here and there. So please visit the website frequently. If there are any changes, you will be notified in the website. Okay, so regularly please visit the website. If there are any changes, you will know. Okay, so next thing is, second point, after CSAB special round 2, after CSAB special round 2, if a candidate is allotted a fresh seat and he is not joining the institute, and if not joining the institute, or if a candidate is not allotted a fresh seat but he is retaining his seat earlier from the CSAB special round 1 or the JOSA, then if he is not accepting that seat, if he is not paying the fees, or if he is not going into that college, then your fees will not be refunded. Okay, if you got a seat after special round 2, or if you are retaining your earlier seat but you are not joining the institute, in both the above cases your fees will not be refunded. Okay, so please choose your choices carefully. So coming to our details, you can also comment if you are having any doubts in the counseling process. We will be replying it as soon as possible. And coming to our campus, Abhyas IIT Prep, which is a part of Gyanvili Academy, that is located in Pragati Nagar, Kukatpalli. Okay, also you can check our websites for the latest updates, and if you are having any admission related query, you can contact to our emails. There is also a Facebook page. Please like and subscribe to our Facebook page. And also, if you are having any queries, you can directly contact those numbers. And we also have a Telegram channel where we will be keeping all the quizzes, puzzles, etc., and daily quotes. Okay, motivational quotes, verbal reasoning, all this stuff will be there in the Telegram app, and that is very free, that is very user friendly, and it is very free to use also. So please subscribe to our Telegram app also, so we will get latest updates, notifications of the exams, you can participate in the daily polls, quizzes, etc. It would be a lot of fun with our Telegram app. Please subscribe to the Telegram app also. Okay, so thank you. If you are having any doubts, let me know in the comments.